Ladada Lovelies, and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make an awesome YouTube thumbnail using Canva. Canva is both a website and an app that you can use to do all sorts of graphic design stuff, and it is really, really great for YouTube thumbnails. You can use it either on your laptop or your smartphone, making it very versatile, and you can really easily create great quality, eye-catching thumbnails for free. Now yes, Canva Pro is available, which you can pay like $18 a month for, but in my opinion, I don't believe it's necessary. You can do so many things with this app on the free version, and I'm going to be showing you guys how to do that today. Before I get the app out, I do want to get into a few things I believe you should consider when creating thumbnails for your channel. First of all, as everyone knows, your thumbnail is a very important part of your video because obviously it is the first impression that people get, and it will potentially make them want to watch your content. However, I wouldn't only think about how your thumbnails work individually, as you should also be considering how they read all together. This is my personal video tab. As you can see, I use the same four colors and rotate through them for each of my thumbnails because I want potential subscribers to look at this and see that it reads like a story. Kind of like you want your Instagram feed to look nice, you want your video feed to look nice too. So before we begin, I would recommend having something that's consistent across your thumbnails. Obviously, I personally chose background colors in order to make my thumbnails consistent, but there are plenty of different elements that you could go with, whether it's the same text style or you use specific colors, that kind of thing. Now that bit of housekeeping is done, let's open up Canva and get started on today's thumbnail, which will have a purple background. We'll get started. Open up Canva. I have used this before. I haven't actually used it for my thumbnails previously, but I have been playing around with it recently and decided that this is the new method that I would like to use. As you can see, I have already previously been looking up YouTube ones, so you can look up different things. As you can see now, there is all of these different ones on there, so whether you want to make a YouTube thumbnail or YouTube channel art, there's all sorts of kind of templates that Canva has available. So we're going with YouTube thumbnail. Whether or not you want to use one of their templates or start blank, that's entirely up to you. Personally, I'm going blank because obviously I already have my own style that I follow. Going to go to photos. I'm getting a bit ahead of myself. I just went ahead and put my background in there. But yeah, basically I use the same four colors. I've got them saved on my phone. I've got them saved on my laptop. So this is what we're using for our background. And now we can start adding some elements in. First of all, I am going to want to add myself in. Ta-da! There I am. That's the photo that I took earlier that I cut out for this thumbnail. So I've just added myself onto the background. A great feature on Canva is that once you've decided where you want something, you can actually lock it into place so that while you're moving other things around, you don't have to worry about accidentally clicking on something else and it's shifting, because let's be honest, that's annoying. So I'm just going to click lock and that won't move now. I can't move it. Text, we'll go with, actually, let's go and see if there's a Canva like specific font. I'm sure there will be because, you know, it's it's their site. There you go, Canva. Is that one? So I'll put that there. YouTube. Just the classic YouTube one, I think. On the thumbnail, I'm going to have Canva YouTube thumbnail tutorial. Tap on that one and change the title. What was it? YouTube thumbnail. And what I'm thinking at this stage is I'm gonna have Canva above, like the Canva, obviously the Canva font, and then I'm going to have YouTube and thumbnail in the same font, and then tutorial in a similar font to Canva if I can find it. So let's see how that goes. I'll try and get the YouTube font. So just click on that, go to the font. That looks about right actually. Yeah, I think that'll do it. Also you can go to spacing and kind of like either move things in or out as to where you think they should be spaced. Same with below and above. If you have like two lines of font, you can choose how far apart they are from each other, which is a good feature because you can't do that on a lot of other programs. There. Like so. Yeah, I like that. If you want to move things in front of or behind other things, you click position and then you can just bring it forward. So I've brought Canva forwards now. So if I bring that down, whoops, I'm on crop. Nope. if you bring it down, then now you can see that it's over the top of your tube, whereas before it was under. Now we need another heading. This one is going to be, where am I? Edit, Canva, YouTube, thumbnail, tutorial. Tutorial. Done. Move that down there so we can see. Go to font. Let's see what we can find. It looks nice and curly. That's not bad, but I reckon we could do better. In case any of you didn't know, any of the fonts with stars on them, well, not stars, sorry, crowns on them, you would need the pro version of the app to use. So that is where your limitations are, but you know, I think I'm managing to create something okay without all of the pro stuff. So it's kind of a personal preference, I guess, as to whether or not you want something different. I've just gone into color and made that one white. A really good feature, as you can see, there is like the color squares at the top. It will show colors already in the thumbnail. So for example, I can see right now that those two blacks of the YouTube and the thumbnail font themselves, let me move that down so I can actually get to the one. Thumbnail. That color is slightly different. So I'm gonna go to font color, just change it to a bit of a lighter black so that it's consistent with the word YouTube above. I think I still want tutorial a little bit bigger. There. I'm gonna bring that thumbnail in front of tutorial, I do believe. So let's go position and send that backwards. See, now it's behind the other font. I think I might move myself a little bit to the right, move myself over a little, so I'm about there. And I want to put emphasis on the fact that this app is free. So I'm thinking maybe like some kind of shape or something. All right, I've still got YouTube searched. There we go, lines and shapes. There we go. I want the color to be red, just like the YouTube symbol. I think maybe behind me. And then I think there's some cute outlines. Yeah, I've used some of them before. I think I like that one. Put that around the circle. Like so. Do I want black or white? White. Black. I think black pops more. So go back down the bottom, click text, add a heading, and edit the text. Free. With an exclamation point. And I'm going to put that inside. How do I want to adjust this? I think I might rotate it a little, give it a bit of quirk. Yes, I like that. But I think maybe I'll move everything down. I think I might change the font of that as well. I don't really dig it with the vibe of the rest of the thumbnail. So, and do I want it to be white? Yes, I do. That pops a lot more. Font, maybe like, do we want it squiggly or do we want it like, that might be good because it's the same as the YouTube font. Oh, let's just have a little look-see at some other ones just to make sure first that we're happy. There we go. I actually think I'm quite happy with that. I do believe that is me done with my thumbnail. I don't need to show you because you can already see on the screen, but I'm pretty happy with that. I like it. Canva supplies the goods. So now that I'm happy with that, I will show you guys how you just export it. It's super easy. Top right corner up here, second symbol from the right, we have a little arrow. Literally just click that and it'll save your image for you. So there you go. Now it's saved. It's ready to go. It'll be in my photos so I can use it. That's how I made my thumbnail, and that is how you can make one too. I really do hope this video helped you guys out. I know it can be super intimidating when you're first starting out on your channel and you really don't know where people create all of these amazing things on YouTube. But I think it's really great to know about Canva because not only can you make your YouTube thumbnail, but you can make your banner, you can make graphics, You can make intros and outros. There are so many options on there, and it is definitely a very, very good site. So whether you want to try it on your computer or your phone, it is very accessible and very easy to use. If you guys have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask me down in the comments and I will do my absolute best to help you out. If you enjoyed this video and you found it helpful, please do not hesitate to give me a massive thumbs up. I really appreciate it, guys. And of course, if you are new here, hello and welcome. My name is Angela. If you would like to join me on a more permanent basis, you can do so by hitting the subscribe button to join our lovely Ladada family, and of course, ding the notification bell to be told when I bring out a new video. Well, that's all from me today, guys. I hope that each and every one of you have an absolutely gorgeous, wonderful, marvelous, beautiful, spectacular, fun day, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Ladada love ya!